Can the problem of dangerous dogs ever really be solved by legislation? Is it something that you can't really legislate to stop?
When you read about these attacks, they are in the home, they are on children that are, and the dog belongs to the family. This is unacceptable. This is people just being totally irresponsible. And those are the sort of things that this package of measures, if it's worded correctly, should actually help.
I'm a volunteer. I'm also responsible for fundraising organisation. We do the rescue gets very little funding from anywhere else, so we have to raise as much money as we can ourselves. So I write out to companies to get donations for the rescue.
My job entails going out assessing dogs when they need to be rehomed. Home checking potential homes, trying to place the right dog with the right family. We use private boarding kennels, so I go over there and I walk the dogs with other volunteers.
The favourite part of my work with the dogs, I think, is the hands-on interaction with the dogs. Some of the dogs that we've had come in from some really dire situations and are in a really bad physical and mental condition, and once we start working with them and eventually rehome them, the satisfaction you get can't be quantified. It's just wonderful seeing the dogs in a new home and happy.
My favourite part of volunteering with the rescue is going to the kennels, working with the dogs, hands-on with the dogs, and seeing them progress.
It's picked up behaviour from another dog. I wouldn't say I've seen a rescue dog acting in an aggressive way. We've seen dogs that bark and lunge and growl because they're frightened, but this is just showing signs of fear, not necessarily signs of aggression.
German Shepherds tend to show their nervousness with aggression.
Muzzling of dogs is primarily to prevent any sort of situations occurring. I mean, some dogs bark. A lot of people don't like seeing a barking dog. So if we can prevent a situation occurring by putting a muzzle on a dog, we'll do it. Some dogs tend to lunge at other dogs as a way of greeting them, not necessarily showing any sort of aggression, but it can be perceived as an aggressive sign, so we can muzzle for prevention more than anything else. I think aggression in dogs is something that definitely can be dealt with, because it's not inbred behaviour, it's a reaction to a situation. By working with the dog, being very gentle with them, handling them, getting them used to situations in a controlled manner that would normally set their aggression or fear off, is something that we do quite a lot with the rescue dogs. And it's just a question of patience and spending the time, and, you know, it can be cured, definitely.
Jess is a little girl that has been with us approximately 9 months. She's 2 years old. For the first 18 months, Jess spent her life with a lady and her seven-year-old son in a flat in a cage the size big enough for a poodle, and was teased constantly by the child. A couple went to see her. It was a private rehoming and they felt sorry for her, so they took her home. Elderly couple, they couldn't manage because obviously Jess has got special needs. Never been outside the flat, never seen another dog. Therefore, they asked us to take her, which we did. She's been in foster now, and Annette continues to work with her.
A German Shepherd's personality, very intelligent, very loyal, can be incredibly gentle. They make very loyal and loving family dogs.
The German Shepherd's personality is absolutely fabulous. They are wonderful dogs if they are trained, if they are loved, if they are looked after, if they're socialised. They are brilliant family dogs. Wonderful, loving companions. They're very, very faithful and won't let you down.
I think German Shepherds are shown in a really negative light in the media. I think primarily because a lot of the German Shepherds are used for guard dogs and rescue dogs, or people automatically presume that that's the way they are. I think through the experience that I've had through having German Shepherds of my own and the dogs in rescue, they can be fantastically loyal dogs. The reason I think they're used in police work and guard work is because they're so intelligent, and they need to be kept busy, to be learning different things. But they're fantastically gentle and loyal dogs, and I know lots of people that have got them with children, and there isn't a problem at all with them.
I think the media are responsible for German Shepherds having a bad name, and also other dogs. I think they sensationalise, you know, when there's been an attack on anybody. First thing you see is either a German Shepherd or a Rottie snarling.
We're finding cases at the moment where pit bull types are being taken away from their families, and actually there's a dog called Lennox in Belfast at the moment that's about to be put down, though his family's fighting for him. He's a therapy dog for the 12-year-old daughter who suffers from chronic asthma.
She loves kids and
so. Yeah, we take her to the rugby and the soccer and all the kids.
And Murray said, oh, he says, yeah, I love that. Dragged across the...
Picked across the...
Oh, God, she might... Oh, God, she might...